There, before we get started, have you liked and subscribed yet? Because I have a lot of great content coming your way, so you're going to want to like and subscribe because I really don't want you to miss out on the tea that I'm spilling. So I'm going to give you 3 seconds to like and subscribe. 1, 2, 3. Thank you for liking and subscribing. Also, what did you think about the free audiobook that I made for you? The link is down below in the comment section. Once you give me your honest feedback on the free audiobook that I made for you, I'm going to pin your comment and give you a shout out. So, Gloria Vanderbilt told Anderson Cooper not to expect a trust fund. He got the estate instead. This article is by Christy D. Zuria. Anderson Cooper is getting a gift he didn't expect. The bulk of the estate of his mother, Gloria Vanderbilt. The CNN anchor, 52, will inherit all of her property except for a Midtown Manhattan, New York co-op, which is going to Vanderbilt's eldest child, Leopold Stan Stokowski, according to documents obtained by Page Six. Middle brother Chris Stokowski is estranged and inherits nothing, the will said. Wow, that's sad. Carter Cooper, Anderson's older brother, took his own life in 1988. Oh my God. Vanderbilt, who died June 17th of stomach cancer at age 95, was estimated by Page Six to be worth $200 million, though a source close to the family said that number was wildly inaccurate and that the value of the estate was closer to $1.5 million. Wow, that's quite a gap. When she turned 21, the heiress socialite fashion entrepreneur inherited north of $4 million, the remainder of a trust fund that had already been tapped by her mother. Cooper told Howard Stern in 2014 that he didn't expect to inherit anything. My mom's made clear to me that there's no trust fund. There's none of that, the journalist said on Stern's radio show as reported by Business Insider. I don't believe in inheriting money. I think it's an initiative sucker. I think it's a curse, Cooper said, who has inherited a lot of money that has gone on to do things in their own life. Who has inherited a lot of money that has gone on to do things in their own life? From the time I was growing up, if I felt that there was some pot of gold waiting for me, I don't know that I would have been so motivated. Cooper's net worth before the inheritance has been estimated at more than $100 million. All right, I got a few comments on this. One, as a parent, how could you have an estranged child? Like, I never understood that. Like, I could see, I'm sorry, but like, as a mother, how could you be okay with your child being estranged from you? Like, and I don't know if she was okay with it, but it's like, you didn't leave him anything. Like, that's your child. Like, I don't care if me and my child, like, don't get along. Like, you know what I mean? It's like, I can't leave him with nothing. Like, granted, I don't know the full story. I don't know the whole story, but I think that's messed up that she didn't leave him anything. Like, that's, I don't know. I just feel like that's so cold. Like, Anderson was clearly her favorite. Like, quite frankly, like, I didn't even know he had other siblings, because for the fact that he got most of the money, like, he got most of the estate. And by the way, like, the way most families go, I don't know how everyone does this, but isn't the oldest child supposed to, like, be like, get the upper hand? I know in a lot of cultures the older child has the upper hand in matters. Like, if I were to be in that position, like, I would just split it evenly. Like, I don't believe in playing favorites with anyone, especially children, so I would just split the estate fairly. But that's me. But I don't know, I feel like that was kind of messed up. Also, I think it's interesting that I actually agree with Anderson when he says, like, when he asked the question, who has inherited a lot of money that has gone on to do things in their own life? He's right. People who inherit money, their motivation just isn't there. They either blow the money or they're just not motivated to make their own money because they have all that money already. So I think it's great that his mother always told him he wasn't going to get anything, because, like, that made him work really hard. And I agree with him. He probably wouldn't have been as motivated. Most people wouldn't be as motivated if they know they're going to get all this money. It's like, it kind of, like, what's the point of working hard if you're going to just have all this money handed to you? So I do agree with him on that. Let me know what your thoughts are on this situation. I would love to get your feedback on this story. I mean, if you were his mother, would you have given your children anything, or would you just have, like, donated to, like, a charity? Let me know in the comment section below. Also, don't forget to share this video with your friends and family. That way they can get the tea also. And don't forget to let me know what you thought about the free audiobook that I made for you. The link is down below in the comment section. And once you give me your honest feedback of the free audiobook that I made for you, I will pin your comment and I'll give you a shout out. Thank you for listening. I look forward to giving you more tea, so stay tuned. Take care. Bye.